Hello guys, I once again welcome you to Tres Kitchen. If you're already a subscriber, we say thank you. But if you're new to this channel, please do us a favor by subscribing to this channel. On today's video, we are going to learn how to prepare gari. Yes, this is homemade gari from A to Z. Please follow the procedure gradually and prepare it at home yourself. When you try this at home, I don't think you buy it from the store anymore. The only ingredient you need is cassava. That is my cassava. You start by peeling the cassava. When this is done, you wash it neatly. Please wash it 2 times. In this corona season, I think this is the best thing you can do. Then we grate it with our grater. Just grate it. Take your time and do it. I don't think this will take away all your time. It's done already, but it's rough. I need to continue with my blender because I need cassava puree now. That is what I need. And I'm going to add my water to this. Yes, just do it as I'm doing. The water will depend on your blender. If you have very sharp one, just add little water. But it depends. If your blender is not very sharp, you can use more water. Yes, after blending, this is what I have now. The cassava puree. I'm going to use my strainer to sieve this. Or you can use very old hair scarf or whatever you have, any material that is light to do this. Yeah, just strain it as I'm doing. Squeeze it very hard to bring out all the juice because we don't need it anymore. It's very simple and you all need to try it at home. That's the juice we have. I don't need this. I'm going to throw it away. And this is my dough. I have my dough now. The next thing is to put it in my sink and add a heavy stone so that all the water left in can come out. I'll leave it in the sink for a day and put it in a tray for 2 days. I kept this for 3 days and this is how it looks like now. It's very dry. You can see, as you can see, wow, that's my cassava dough now. It already looks like gari. Gari, yes. Yes, it's time to fry. And please, when frying, the fire needs to be very low. Please don't preheat your saucepan. Do not preheat the saucepan because gari doesn't need heat, so much heat. All that you need is very low heat. I'm telling you this. And when frying gari, you can't add too much at a time. You should be bit by bit, bit by bit. Because if you add more at a time, your gari will turn into something else. If you don't take care, it will turn like a bar. And those you don't know about, eba is like gari mixed with hot water. That's how your gari will turn into. But we don't want anything like that. We want it very smooth, like the gari we buy from the store. So just add it little by little, as I'm doing here. My gari is already done and it looks good, just like the one we buy from outside. Oh, I'm proud of myself, and I'm sure if you prepare this for your kids, they will love it, and you love it yourself, and your husband will be proud of you as a woman. So please try it at home. Try it at home, because this corona era, we don't know what we are going to meet. The one serving the gari, do you know what the person did to their hands before touching the gari? Has the person washed their hand before touching the gari? You have no idea. So the best thing to do is to prepare it yourself at home so that you and your family can enjoy it, as I'm going to do now. The gari looks good. Oh my God. I wish you try this. Please try this. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and also follow all our social media handles. When I say Tres Kitchen, you respond. Spice up your cooking. Thank you.